Hey guys, how are you today? We are back again for a specific video that I'm often asked about. You know, in Unreal we create a lot of stuff, great simulation, but when you want to import it in your sequencer to make like a render cinematic things, it doesn't work. How to get straightforward for this principle using fracture mode? I'm here to help and I'll do my best. Little disclaimer for people watching this video, I assume for this tutorial you know a little bit Unreal, the sequencer, and how to use fracture mode in the simplest way, of course. So, to get started, of course, we need a static mesh. So here I used Bridge, and I get this Japanese statue. I just drag and drop it into my scene. And now, I select my asset here, I go to selection mode, and I choose fracture. Here, the first thing you need, and I assume you know it, is just to generate a new geometry collection that will get all the fracture information. So click here, you can create and place your geometry collection where you want. And now we go simple, as I said, so I just select for this example uniform fracture. I go down here, I fracture once, and why not twice. That's it for the fracture part. So the fracture part is done. What you can do now is go back to your selection mode into your viewport, and if you want to see a simulation of what you did, there you are, I have to just bring a little bit higher my model and just simulate here. And now you see the fracture just in front of your eyes. But what we want to do, it's not just use like gravity. We want to use like specific actor called anchor points and master field. This will help us to create like a solid base that will not simulate, and like an impact, point of impact that we will control. And the purpose here is to really control what we do and control all the animation of the simulation. So to get these two actors I just talked about, so let's place back our model on the floor. I go back to my content drawer, and what I want to do now is to go to settings and search for show engine content. From there, I will have access to more contents from and within the engine. I just click here and I will go for, as I said, ankle here. What I advise you when you pick something in the engine, just and always copy paste into your own folder. Don't use it directly in the engine, because if you make some modification on the assets, they will change for all your next projects. So I take my FS ankle field, drag and drop here, and select copy. I will now get my master field and do the same. Now I have my two actors, and what I do now, I just place it where I want for the ankle field. After, I can drag and drop my master field here and place it where I want the impact to be. So now the important things to do is to set up our anchor field into our object. In order to do that, you have to select your objects here, go to the detail panels and search for initialization field here. You see we have zero array, so we have to create one here, and just in the index select our ankle field. And if you now press the simulation, you see that the ankle field does its job and the impact is here. Remember guys, if you don't want to see this material, this texture in your model here, select your statue here, go to the details panel, and under general here, deactivate the show bounce color. And we have our original texture of our model. Okay, so now everything is set up. I just need to get a cache of the simulation, save it, and bring this into my sequencer. The first thing you need to do, of course, it's to get sure of your simulation that you are happy with it. Remember that for each simulation you launch, the result will be different. So here I just launch it and see that my anchor field is working, my fracture is really simple but effective, and I'm happy with it for this example. Okay, I can go for the next step. So now I have to select my object here, and I will go to Actor, under Chaos, and create Cache Manager. Here will ask me where I want to save these assets. I will go there, and I'm going to just name it CCC Statue. I save everything. And this is a really important part, because as you see, now I have my Gcache collection here. I have my Chaos cache collection in my content drawer, but as soon as I created this asset here, I have a new one that has been created in my outliner. Remember, I don't have to click and drag this Chaos cache into my viewport. It will create problems and you won't understand easily the next parts. You just have to create, save it into your content drawer and that it. Now I select this Chaos cache here. I have an 8 number over there because I just made some simulation before this tutorial. It's normal, but normally we'll just have for you Chaos cache manager. There, if I look into my detail panel, I see that my cache collection is CCC statue. So it's referring to what I just created into my content drawer here. I have my observed components under index with the cache name of my statue. So everything makes sense. And now I have start time, okay, start mode, and the cache mode. This is the most important thing, because here you can see that it's in the record mode. So when I will launch my simulation, it will record and save the simulation I just launched. So for example, I just launched my simulation here. I wait a little bit that everything is really simulated, and I press stop. So now I have recorded my simulation. In order to watch what you just created with this geocache that you recorded just now, go to Chaos Cache Manager here, and into cache mode, go now to static pause. And if you play now with the start time, you will see your simulation. Here. So in terms of a logical way, I would say, we created all our workflow, and now the last part is to bring this into our sequencer. In order to do that, first, of course, we have to create a sequencer. So go to your content drawer here, left click, under cinematics, level sequence. I will call that Chaos Chaos here. And really simple from there, I will grab my object here, add it into my sequencer. And now I will just go to the Chaos Cache Manager here. And I go back to zero at start time, and you see this little icon here. Just click on it. It will bring your actor you just selected in your outliner, and it will get the exact track needed in order to keyframe all of this stuff into your sequencer. You don't have to manually get your Chaos Cache Manager and create a track. No, just click this icon now. And you see, I have my Chaos Cache Manager with the track of the start time, a key here. And what I have to do now, let's say I go to frame 105, and make it here. And now I have my simulation in my sequencer, and if I play here, so not the simulation but the sequencer itself, voila. And with this we can go further, like adding an object with an animation in the impact. We can add a Niagara effect with smoke, explosion, etc, etc. So guys, I hope now you understand this process more easily with this video. I do my best to make it simple. If you have any question or requests, leave a comment. If you like this video, leave a like, subscribe, it helps me a lot. Don't forget it guys. And I just tell you now, see you.